Hey there, homemakers. Welcome back to another video. If you are new here, hi, my name is Angel. I am your digital homemaking coach at Habits of a Homemaker. I teach women how to cultivate godly character and habits within their homes for the glory of God. Also, if this is your first time tuning in, make sure that you check out part one to this video where I share the five things that I do before my husband gets home from work. So if you have not checked that video out, I will link it right here and you can check that out first. And I'll also have it in the description box as well. All right, ladies. So now I'm going to be sharing with you all the five things that I do after my husband gets home from work, okay? And like I mentioned before in the previous video, these are not necessarily the only things I do, but these are the five essential things that I want to hone in on to make sure I do after my husband gets home from work. Okay, the first thing is to greet him with love and joy. So when my husband gets home from work, normally I know when he's about to walk in the door because he always calls me after he gets off. So we're chit-chatting before he gets home. And also when he opens up the door, our door makes a sound and it lets us know that someone is coming in the house. So when he is walking into the house, I make sure to physically greet him. So if I am in the middle of doing something like washing the dishes, tidying up the kitchen, I actually stop what I'm doing and I go physically greet my husband. Now, obviously, if I'm in the middle of changing a diaper, I can't just like, you know, leave the baby on the changing table and then rush to go see him. But if it's something that I can stop what I'm doing, I like to do that. This is not something that my husband has required of me or asked me to do. This is something that I personally, as a wife, love to do and want to do to receive my husband when he comes home. I don't want my husband to walk in the door and him to not be acknowledged. I don't want my husband to walk in the door and I'm shouting from across the room like, oh, hey, and then continuing to do what I'm doing. I want for my husband to feel honored when he walks into his home, especially after he has worked a long day to provide for our family. So when he comes through that door, I stop what I'm doing and I go and I greet my baby with love and joy. And we have this thing where we give each other a certain amount of kisses and just different things when he comes through the door. So I look forward to that. He looks forward to that. And I come and I kiss him and I greet him. And we all have this thing where me, the kids, we all just shout, "Daddy's home!" Like, they're so excited to see him and we all just stop what we're doing. It's a natural thing. The kids, they naturally do it. I don't even have to force them. I never ask them to do that. They are so excited to see their daddy. When they see his car pull up, you know, like in the driveway, they are so excited to see him. And everybody stops what they're doing and we rush to the door to greet him. And we're like, "Daddy's home, yay, baby." Like everybody's excited. And that joy sparks, that joy just brings so much life. Like, can you imagine after being out in a world all day where the world is trying to beat you down, where the world is trying to criticize you and where people don't care, and then you walking into your home and everybody who you're working so hard for and who you love so much and who you do anything for stops what they're doing and they turn to greet you with so much love and excitement and joy. Can you imagine how that makes you feel, right? Versus you walking home and you open the door after all of that and nobody cares. Nobody says anything. Nobody acknowledges you. You can barely get anything out of anybody. That would really make somebody feel low, I think, you know? So I make sure to greet my husband with love and joy when he comes through that door. All right, the second thing is I listen and pay attention. So I make sure that my ears are perked, honey, okay? If I know that my husband has had a long day or I know something stressful happened at the job, I am not going to, you know, start going on a tangent about how stressful my day was or what's going on with the kids right now. I just know that's not the time for that. I want to make sure that I'm listening to see, okay, what are we working here with? You know, what kind of day has he had? And how can I be the best help me to him? How can I encourage him, uplift him? What is it that he needs right now? If I am doing something else, if I'm on the phone, then I make sure that that stuff comes to a halt. My close friends, we already have this thing. We have a mutual respect for one another where if our husband walks through the door, it's like, all right, girl, I'm gonna talk to you later, you know, and it's no hard feelings. It's nothing involved because we know our husband is home and we want to give him that undivided attention and that love and respect. So I am not on the phone when my husband gets home and I'm like, hey, boo. And I'm just talking and running my mouth on the phone and didn't even acknowledge him. And I'm on the phone 2 hours later and he's been home. You know, I don't do that. So I make sure that I am paying attention. I make sure that I'm listening to him and what his needs are and just seeing what he needs from me. All right. The third thing is I bring him something to drink and snack on. So a lot of times my husband comes home, it just depends how the day is going. Sometimes if he's like really hungry and he, you know, would like dinner right then and there, then we'll go ahead and we'll eat dinner. But he's feeling like he just wants to wait till after the kids go to bed for him and I to have dinner. Then I will just bring him something to snack on. I'll bring him something that I made earlier or something that he likes. And I'll just bring him that snack, bring him something cold to drink and just allow him to just be refreshed and have something to just hold him over and something to kind of just boost his energy up a little bit. Which brings me to number four, and that is allowing him to just relax and regroup for a minute. You know, I know, trust me, ladies, I know that it can be so tempting and I don't always succeed in this. I know that it can be so tempting sometimes to just like, husband's coming home and he's here and you just want to say, okay, here's the baby. I'm about to go to the bathroom and just be able to close the door, right? I understand that. I really do. But I also like to think, okay, my husband, this is his first time being at home all day. He's been away from the home all day long because he's been at work. And so just allowing him, I know that my husband leaves a lot of people and I know that he has people pulling on him and calling him and requesting things from him all day long. And so I don't want to be another person that is immediately, as soon as he walks the door, I need you to do this, 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 this needs to be done, this. We have to be so careful that we're not just putting demands and pulling and sucking and draining our husbands when they just come through the door. That doesn't mean that you don't make your, you know, requests known or if you need something that you don't ask, but it's a time and a place for everything. And this is how you have to use discernment and you have to be very attentive to your husband to see when is the proper time for that. And also in your demeanor, how am I going about that? Let's just use this as an example. Let's say that the trash needed to be taken out and your husband didn't take it out. Okay, when he comes to the door, you don't have to say, this trash has been in here all day. It's stinking. I need you to take this trash out. I cannot stay in this house another minute with this trash. Okay. We don't want to do that. So let's say after your husband is kind of been in for a minute and you say, oh, hey, honey, you know, the trash is a little bit full. I can put it, you know, by the door for you. So when you're ready, you can take it out. You know, or whatever, or just let him know in a soft and gentle way. Because sometimes, ladies, our husbands, it's not that they don't want to do it. They may just have so much on their mind that they may have actually just forgot. They have so many different things that they are dealing with and that they're handling. And sometimes they just need that gentle reminder. But we don't want to nag them and just drill into them and just, you know, just be like aggressive with it. You want to be soft and gentle and kind and patient. So just know that that is okay. So I like to allow my husband to just have a minute. They need a moment to just mentally regroup. Give them that time. All right. And the fifth and final thing, and that is to spend quality time with him. When my husband gets home, y'all, I know that the hours are limited. I know that we have to put the kids to bed and we have 4 kids to put to bed, okay? And so it's a lot dealing with that and trying to make sure that dinner's cooked, the kids are ready for bed, you gotta clean up them after dinner. Like, it's so many different things to just do at nighttime. But I wanna make sure that every moment that I have when he comes home, that I have maximized it, and that we actually spend quality time together. So we're spending quality time together as a family and we're spending quality time together as a married couple. So get that time in. I know, okay, Angel, you can wash the dishes. after he goes to sleep. What benefit would it be, besides the dishes just being washed earlier, instead of sitting on the couch with my husband and, you know, us just like snuggling up and talking, or us watching a show together, or just whatever, instead of me spending time with him like that, me saying, oh, well, I'm gonna go ahead and wash these dishes, and then that's all I'm doing, and I'm in the kitchen and he's in the living room, and I'm not able to spend that time to connect with him and to have that quality time with him. Those dishes can wait. The kitchen cleanup can wait. So making sure that I am spending quality time with my husband. Those are the five things, essential things that I like to do after my husband gets home from work. I hope that you all enjoyed this video, that you found something in here that could be of a benefit to you and that maybe you could incorporate after your husband gets home from work. Also, be sure to share in the comment section below some things that you do after your husband gets home from work. Let's share some tips so that we can be the best wives and homemakers that we can possibly be for the glory of God and for the benefit of our families. I would love to hear from you all. If you are not subscribed, please make sure that you do. I would love for you to join and be a part of our homemaking community here. You can hit that red subscribe button. It is free and it does not cost anything to subscribe. Hit the like button if you enjoyed this video. And I cannot wait to chat with you all again very soon. Love you, ladies, and have a blessed day. Bye, ladies.